All right, here we are with Roxie's team. I was on a long hiatus. I don't know if you noticed. That was not intentional at all. You know how you come up with a lot of ideas for different shit you want to do, this being one of them? And then it's hard for you to focus on other ones because you're a little burnt out on those, and then you want to go to another one predominantly. Yeah, that's kind of the scenario I was stuck in for the past, like, week or so. But we're back into it. We're going to get back into the swing of things, and we'll go from there. First off, we have a Jolly Scallopede holding a Lychee Berry with Poison Point, Megahorn, Earthquake, Toxic Spikes, Rock Slide, Mild Seviper holding a Shuka Berry with Shed Skin, Dark Pulse, Dragon Tail, Sludge Wave, Glare, Hasty Garbodor holding a Salac Berry with Stench, Gunk Shot, Rock Blast, Clear Smog, Stockpile, Jolly Crobat holding a Payapa Berry with Inner Focus, Cross Poison, Brave Bird, U-Turn, Tailwind, Jolly Drapion holding a Citrus Berry with Battle Armor, Cross Poison, Night Slash, Fire Fang, Acupressure, and a Calmamoongus holding a Ganlin Berry with Effect Spore, Toxic Spore, Giga Drain Substitute. Alright, here we... Elisa. Alright, I wonder how this is gonna work out. I mean, Zebstrika has Flame Charge for its super effective move. But that doesn't concern me, like, in any capacity. Ampharos' signal weakness. No, it's not super effective on Drapion. Drapion's only weakness is ground. Stunfisk and Electros. Electros kind of worries me. I mean, I think we're fine. It's just Electros that has me worried. Okay, first things first, we're gonna just straight up go brute force on that Electros Megahorn. Dark Pulse. I guess just stockpile. Are you fucking kidding me? This definitely isn't killing now. Okay, at least that's what you start with. I kind of didn't consider ground moves. Earth Power. That... Damn. I'm already low on HP. If you miss this Megahorn, I swear to God, I'll be pissed. That Salad Berry was enough? Really? Okay, well, there goes Obstrika. Okay, Dark Pulse should kill it before he gets the chance to attack. Now Stunfisk is gonna probably Earth Power or Stone Edge Garbodor? Yeah, I figured. Saw a kill with anything. Alright, who could you send in? I could definitely see Emolga coming out. I don't know if Ampharos or Galvantula will come out, though. I'll send out Crobat. Call me crazy. Okay. So, no Emolga, really. Alright, we are going to Earthquake. I think I'm going to change my mind. My plan with Crobat was a U-turn. You have U-turn. Damn, I'm butchering my fucking sentence. You do have U-turn. Okay, that answers my butchered question. Alright, fuck it. This is kind of ruining my plan, but... Here we go. I was gonna U-turn. And then switch to Drapion. I mean, that is also a good trick. Damn. I can't Earthquake if I want to do that. Fuck it. I guess I'm not using U-turn. Almost. That'll take care of Stunfisk. Ampharos, maybe if it crits? Definitely with a crit. That's to be expected. It's fine. It's just Ampharos and Emolga. I mean... But I also only have Drapion and Amoongus. And Swiper. Oh, Emolga's gonna go to the far right, not the middle. Shit, why am I putting Amoongus here? Kind of out of the loop. I really am. Yeah, I was right. Okay, damn. I did not think that one through. At least that'll take care of Ampharos. The question shouldn't have been, why did I put Amoongus there? It should have been, why didn't I put Drapion there? Because Amoongus is going to get hit by Acrobatics no matter where it's at. It's just Drapion would be able to do damage to both if it were in the middle. But now I have to waste a turn shifting. Whoops. Isn't Sludge Wave randomized? I guess I'm thinking of Psy Wave. Never mind. Oh, that hits everyone nearby. I mean, I guess that's another reason I haven't been using it. It would be an excuse for having not used it yet. Bro, it's almost over. Just give up. Why do you have to be... Why do you have to have a track, too? There. Oh, yeah. Not bad. Nah, I wouldn't say not bad. It was alright. Okay, either Cress or Roxie. It's Roxie. Well, it's a mirror match. Let's see how this goes. All right. Why do you talk so much? She had so many fucking text boxes. All right. Skullpeed Earthquake. Skullpeed Rock Slide on my Skullpeed and Crobat. Drapion Fire Fang on Skullpeed and Amoongus. Alright, we're gonna Earthquake. We're gonna swap into Crobat. We're gonna Rock Blast. Oh, and I guess Garbodor to Rock Blast on Skullpeed. I guess Crobat Brave Bird on Amoongus. I keep forgetting different moves, damn. Would 5 even kill? Well, with a crit, yeah. With a crit, you only need 4. I don't know if 5 would have killed. Okay, you're gonna do your usual. Brave Bird, then Amoongus. Why did you send out Crobat? Is it because of Skullpeed? That would make sense. Wait, what? Oh. I misremembered that I was using Brave Bird on Crobat. No, I used it on Amoongus. Because I just saw the super effective, not the substitute. I mean, it removes the substitute at least. Garbodor's taking care of it with Rock Blast, so I guess it's not the worst thing in the world. Because Crobat's definitely going for Skullpeed, right? Yeah. Okay. Just make it easier to kill with Rock Blast, why don't you? Does it take 4? Yeah, it does. Why am I hitting all of these? How am I hitting all of these? That's kind of annoying. Who do you have left? Drapion and Seviper? Could go Drapion. Crobat's gonna definitely take care of Amoongus with Fire Fang. So, I'm not worried about Amoongus. So, if you only have Drapion and Seviper, definitely don't send an Amoongus. Probably just go Drapion. Although, Seviper does more damage. Alright, we're gonna go Seviper. I changed my mind. Okay, I was kind of hoping Seviper would go to the far left. I don't like that. Especially since this is a special attacking Seviper. Damn it. Alright, well, I gotta make a second call. How about we swap an Amoongus? Hope that Drapion decides to attack Amoongus and just get a free switch in. Actually. No. Dark Pulse Amoongus. U-turn Drapion. Rock Blast Seviper. Maybe it's not the worst thing. Oh, I forgot you were asleep, to be honest. Lovely. Shift. Go Fire Fang. Rock Blast. If you can wake up. You should wake up next turn. Got the average at least. Yeah, that didn't last too long. Are you fucking kidding me? You tried to paralyze a Crobat too before I got the hell out of dodge with the U-turn. I don't know if this will kill. Oh, it does. Okay. Well, at least I don't have to worry about paralysis. I just gotta hope Drapion doesn't target or kill Crobat. Really? That is the worst stat you could have rose. Shit. That is the worst stat that could have gotten a buff. I think we're fine. I don't think it matters. Okay, we're good. Sheesh. That was a fight. That was definitely a fight. Always background noise. Alright, it's either Chili or Clay. Please, Chili, 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 Chili. Blah. Fuck. What could I possibly fucking do? Well, let's figure it out. We could either die, 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 or die. It's not pretty. Crobat would be good. Only against Claydol? No, not even. Actually, it's bad against everything, because Excadrill is Rock Slide. Claydol has Psychic. Crocodile has Rock Slide, Seismitoad has Ice Punch, Mamoswine has Stone Edge, and Golurk has Stone Edge. Yeah, I don't think I should be using Crobat. Shit. Fuck. What do I do? I don't think Megahorn's gonna get me out of anything. I don't know what Seismitoad is planning to do first thing, but probably Earth Power on Seviper. Golurk is probably planning the Stone Edge Scolipede, or just Earthquake, which honestly sounds like the best scenario. Excadrill is probably gonna Sword Stance unless it sees a drill run kill. So if I can play off of that and hope everything I just said is correct. Seviper, I definitely need to swap into Crobat to at least waste that turn and just use my speed to my advantage. Golurk is definitely going to want a Stone Edge. So if I swap to anyone, it's either a Moongus or Drapion. Probably a Moongus. I know Seismitoad has Ice Punch. You're going to swap into Crobat. Now you Excadrill's gonna drill run somebody. So Viper would be the best play for it to hit. My moves honestly aren't gonna cut it. So either I stay in or swap the Drapion, but I don't think that's a... I don't know if I should do that. Excadrill's fast enough for Drapion to probably get outsped, alright? It's my third fastest Pokemon, but... I don't know. We can try this. At least a hit. Okay, Sword Stance. Muddy Water. Interesting. Earthquake. Interesting. I'll take that. I'll take that any day. I mean, could you expect anything else with Scalipede, though? Or not Scalipede, Garbodor. I don't know if I'm going to take that anymore. That... No, Crobat should kill it. Alright, I need a decent swap in. If I get rid of Excadrill, he's most likely... I don't know who he's going to send him, because literally everything he has is so fucking good. Especially Claydol and Mamoswine. Crocodile maybe not so much. Judging by how the AI probably thinks. I'll set up Substitute and it'll just end. I don't know if it's really worth trying. U-turn Seismitoad and then Earthquake. This is... No, that was a terrible idea. Okay, well, Drapion's gonna have to get hit by an Earthquake. Shit. I did not think that one through. It's either Drapion or Seviper. I think Drapion's probably my least useful Pokemon. All it has is Night Slash for Claydol. And I guess for Golar, too. I don't know, maybe it'll take it. Still don't like that damage. You're bulky, right? You can live it. Okay, that's fine. So two are down. I don't think I've lost anything yet. But I shouldn't celebrate. Oh no, I have lost one. It's Garbodor. Come on. You know you want to kill. That kills. Oh my god. I still can't celebrate. I know it's 5 against 2. I still can't celebrate. It's 4 against 2. I sent in anyone. Go and Crobat. Use my speed to my advantage. Go for a U-turn on Crocodile. That would be my best play. U-turn Crocodile. Just in case it doesn't kill Megahorn Crocodile. Which I don't think it will. Okay. I don't know how I pulled this off. Although Mamoswine still has me very concerned. That's fine. Dog in the background growling. As soon as it uses substitute, I guess it doesn't like substitutes. I don't blame it. I don't like substitute either. Did I call my dog an it? It's my dog. Yeah, I don't think he's happy with me after that one. He's really not happy with me. This should work. I think that's GG's. Why does he have to growl when I'm almost done? He's literally, no, I can tell you right now, he's literally under his blanket growling. He's not dreaming. He just got comfy. Physically, not emotionally, apparently. Anyway, I don't know how I managed that clay fight. Holy fuck. Holy mother of shit. Oh my god. I figured it out somehow. I don't know how. There were really good plays in that, though. Yeah, he's growling in celebration in the background. I don't even know if it's picking it up, but if it is, celebratory growl. Anyway, that was Roxie's team. I'll see you on the next one. 300 hours? Holy shit.